I should be done. What I think will be done really is that leaders, there are two things that I think determine or assist one to become a successful leader in life, beyond qualification. And number one, firstly, is for one to understand what I call the objective learning. In other words, understanding nature, the laws that govern nature, as opposed to your subjective reality. Now, let me now give you an example. During elections, well, I see it even in the US and even in South Africa, around the world, everywhere, politicians stand in front of people and promise them things. So, every South African, if you vote for me, I'll build you houses. It's a good dream, isn't it? It's a lovely thing. And you can clap hands for that. Sure, you can vote for that person to be a leader or to be a president. It's nice, it's easier for any Democratic leader here or a Republican to come here to say to you, or to the learners in schools, in high school, and say, all of you here will graduate with math and science as your major. And I'll give you scholarships to go and study teaching or engineering and technology. That's a lovely dream. All of us will clap hands, and I'm sure we'll vote for you on that basis. See, that's subjective. Those are wishes. That's what you wish. But then the objective reality, a real leader comes and says, how practical is that? How possible? Can I really take all students who completed their grade 12 and give them scholarship for free? How possible that is? So a leader must sit down and calculate and say, these are my wishes, but this is what nature will allow me. This is what is realizable. This is what is practical. This is what I can achieve with the resources given the time that I have as well. So that's what the leader must do. Otherwise, you then end up losing the confidence of the people you're leading because you keep on promising but you don't do it. And then they end up calling you enough. You'll tell me about time if I'm running out of time. Now, as part of that, we have to understand the complex objective reality. As part of that, it's very crucial that you study, you understand the modern society, how people think and how people respond to the policies, how people conceptualize life, how people see themselves, how an individual see her or himself in relation to the community and the society. And the impact of technology and other things, culture, religion, and those kind of things. You need to understand those things so that whatever that you do as a leader, it complements those kind of things that I've already explained. Because there will always be a conflict between you, but you must understand that. But also, the second thing, the first one is the objective reality. The second thing, which is more important, it's what in South Africa we call Ubuntu. It means I am because you are. So you after understanding the objective reality, you need to make sure that the people you lead, doesn't matter whether it's a school, whether it's an university, whether it's a company, wherever you are, make sure that people can relate to each other because they are you. People must relate beyond color. You must move that thing. We've discussed issues of color for more than 2,000 years now. When 2015, and race is still a problem, religion is still a problem. Some people can't speak, can't even share food or sit on a table because the other one belongs to this religion, the other one belongs to this religion. It can't be correct. And why is it important for teachers? It's because teachers, social workers, psychologists, etc., have the most unique opportunity. As a teacher, you sit in a class with different, with learners from different backgrounds in terms of gender, gays, lesbians, African Americans, Native Americans, Mexicans, Africans, Asians. You sit with them, and these people, they come into the class with their own personal experiences. Remember, some of them, they have even been lied to by their teachers, by their pastors, by whoever in their community. They told them, you. You are better than everyone in this world. You Your race is superior than them. Your religion, you're praying the real God. Others are not praying the real God. So when they come to the class, you have an opportunity to say to them, let's put aside all these things that divide us and look the commonalities, things that brings us together. And at the end of the day, it will come back to you. Because all of us are the same inside. So for me, this personally, these are the most two important things that any leader around the world must have. If you don't have this, then you'll probably reproduce the Nazi Germany. Because to you, some people are important than the others. So I don't know if you understand that, but we'll